respected dignitaries on the dais, in front of the dais, and those who are connected through net. I am very thankful to Sir Syed Foundation Northeast India for organizing this function, and also I am thankful for inviting me on this auspicious occasion. Speaking about Sir Syed Sahab, it's very difficult to say something about him in a few words. He was such a prolific reader and writer, a social reformist, and I consider him as a brave person because he started this modern education, science and technology, at a time when majority of the people were against it. A fearless person, as a crusader, he started and successfully he established schools, Ghazipur, and of course MAO became UST later on after his death. But his idea was there should be a college or there should be a UST like Oxford and Cambridge when he started MAO. That was his idea, because he went to UK, he was given that Order of Star of India. After that, when he came back, he wrote about it. I want a university here which will be on the line of Oxford and Cambridge. I am really thankful that at that time he thought about it, and that is why today we are all here. We studied there, wonderful university no doubt, and a wonderful atmosphere, as our chancellors have said here. Memorial days of AMU. And second thing about him, I will only say what he said about Islam. What Haq Sahab has said was about his vision. He said, "He don't show the face of Islam. Show your face as a follower of true Islam, representing tolerance, pity, knowledge. These were the characters which a human being have to imbibe. And if every one of us imbibe such characters, it will be Ram Raj. It will be heaven." So what he said was wonderful, and at a time when he was having lot of opposition, not only from his own community, from other communities also. So great man, no doubt about it. And I am very happy on the topics selected today's panel discussion. Vision, Sir Syed vision, and role of alumni. And second topic is carrying forward the legacy of Sir Syed. Now, carrying forward the legacy, of course, with time the legacy will change. There is no doubt about it. What was the situation one century ago, more than one century ago, is different. Today it is different. At that time we were ruled by a outside force, British India, and now we are independent. We have to take every community, every Indian along with us, and that is why I salute Haq Sahab that he has come up with such a wonderful history here. And no mention or anywhere of any word of any one community. Nobody can say there is no discrimination, because everybody has to be carried forward for the development of the country. You cannot restrict yourself to one community. Now, only thing which I still consider what is required is women education. In India, in all regions I am talking about, women are not treated at par. Most of the in our families we think that women are for the house works and the kitchen work and all these things. Although they have the equal capacity, or I will say more capacity in certain fields, So what we require now is educate our women, bring up them at par so that the nation progresses faster than what it is progressing now. How to implement it is very difficult because most of the families I have seen, they are reluctant to send the girls for higher education. Up to a limit they are agreeing, but after that they stop sending them for education. The facilities in the schools and colleges are less for them. In such a situation, this is one thing which can be done, what I was thinking while coming here, is like we have a system of reservation. The communities which are not up to the level, they are giving reservation. So in schools and colleges, if this is introduced, okay, 50% students will be girls, probably the institutions will themselves go forward and bring the girls and women this thing to the institute. Because if you allow this thing, okay, if you have a 1,000 capacity, you have to have 500 girls as students, they themselves will move forward and bring as much as possible. So this is one aspect which I think has to be looked after by the, I will not say only the ERD Foundation, but everybody, one of us. I'll salute Haksa for the excellent facilities he has created here, from a humble rise, from a very small place of Assam, he started, and within last 2 decades, he has come up with this wonderful university. I took a round before coming here, and I was highly impressed. He is the true crusader. He is the, I will say, the actual person who is carrying the torch of Sir Syed Saab. With these few words, I will say thank you very much for inviting me once more. Thank you.